Hey pal, feeling blue, don't know what to do. Hey pal, I mean you, yeah, come here and kill a president. No job, cupboard bare, one room, no one there. Hey pal, don't despair, you wanna shoot a president. Come on and shoot a president. Some guys think they can't be winners. First prize often goes to rank beginners.
How much?
$450. Ivor Johnson, 32. Rubber handles. Al, stand
all right, give me.
Hey, kid, failed your test. Dream girl, unimpressed. Show her you're the best. If you can shoot a president, you can get the prize with the big blue eyes. Skinny little thighs and those big blue eyes. Everybody's got the right to be happy. Don't stay mad, life's not as bad as it seems. If you keep your goal in sight, you can climb to any height. Everybody's got the right to their dreams.
Deal,
mister.
I said deal.
You wait your turn.
It is my turn.
I've a chance.
Hey,
my
watch
turn.
It now. No violence. Hey, fella. Feel like you're a failure, bailiff on your tail, your wife run off for good. Hey, fella, feel misunderstood, come here and kill a president.
Okay! Moron!
Oh, what's a wrong boy, boss? I treat you crummy,
trouble with your tummy.
This'll bring you some relief, here and give us some hail to the chief.
Yeah!
You give me price!
Anything you want!
I want price! You give me price!
Only $8, cheap for anything you want.
Everybody's got the right to be different. Even though at times they go to extremes. Aim for what you want a lot. Everybody gets a shot. Everybody's got the right to their dreams. Yo, baby, looking for a thrill, the Ferris wheel is that way.
No, baby, this requires skill. Okay, you wanna give it a try. Jeez, lady, give the guy some room, the bumper cars are that way. Please, lady, don't forget that guns can go boom.
Hey, gang, look who's here. There's our pioneer. Hey, chief, loud and clear.
Everybody's got the right to be happy. Say enough, it's not as tough as it seems. Don't be scared, you won't prevail. Everybody's free to fail. No one can be put in jail for their dreams. Free country
means your dreams can come true.
Be a scholar,
make a dollar.
Free country means they listen to you.
Scream and holler.
Grab them by the collar.
Free country
means you don't have to sit.
That's it.
And put up with the shit.
Everybody's got the right to some sunshine.
Everybody.
Not the sun, but maybe one of its beams.
One of its beams.
Rich man, poor man, black or white. Pick your apple, take a bite. Everybody, just hold tight to your dreams. Everybody's got the right.
ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States, Abraham Lincoln.
Sic semper tyrannis! Sic semper tyrannis! Sic semper tyrannis! Sic semper tyrannis!
Someone tell the story, someone sing the song. Every now and then the country goes a little wrong. Every now and then a madman's bound to come along. Doesn't stop the story, story's pretty strong. Doesn't change the song. Johnny Booth was a handsome devil, got up in his rings and fancy silks. Had him a temper but kept it level, everybody called him Wilkes. Why did you do it, Johnny? Nobody agrees. You who had everything, what made you bring a nation to its knees? Some say it was your voice had gone, some say it was booze. Some say you killed a country, John, because of bad reviews. Johnny lived with a grace and glitter, kinda like the lives he lived on stage. Died in a barn in pain and bitter, 27 years of age. Why did you do it, Johnny? Throw it all away. Why did you do it, boy? Not just destroy the pride and joy of Illinois, but all the USA. Your brother made you jealous, John. You couldn't fill his shoes. Was that the reason? Tell us, John, along with bad reviews.
They're coming. They'll be here any minute.
I need your help. I've got to write this. I can't hold the pen.
Johnny, they found us. We gotta get out of here.
Not till I finish this.
Johnny!
No! Have you seen these papers? Do you know what they're calling me? A common cutthroat. A hired assassin. This one says I'm mad.
Oh, we must have been mad to think we could kill a president and get away with it.
We did get away with it. He was a bloody tyrant and we brought him down. And I will not have history think I did it for a bag of gold or in some kind of rabid fit.
Johnny, we have to go.
No! I have to make my case. I need you to take it down.
We don't have time!
Take it down. An indictment of the former President of the United States, Abraham Lincoln, who is herein charged with the following high crimes and misdemeanors.
They say your ship was sinking, John.
One, that you did ruthlessly provoke a war between the states, which cost some 600,000 of my countrymen their lives. Two,
you'd started missing cues.
Two, that you did silence your critics in the North by hurling them into prison without benefit of charge or trial. Three.
They say it wasn't Lincoln, John.
Shut up. Three.
You merely had a slew of bad reviews.
I said shut up.
Booth! I have 50 soldiers out here, Booth! Dig yourselves up or we'll set fire to the barn!
Don't shoot! I'm coming out!
No! I have given up my life for one act. Do you understand? Do not let history rob me of its meaning. Pass on the truth. You're the only one who can. Please.
He said, damn you, Lincoln, you had your way.
Tell the boy.
With blood you drew out of blue and gray.
Tell till they listen.
He said, damn you, Lincoln, and damn the day. You out of USA. He said,
hunt me down, smear my name, say I did it for the fame. What I did was kill the man who killed my country. Now the South land will mend, now this bloody war can end, because someone slew the tyrant, just as Brutus slew the tyrant.
He said, damn you, Lincoln, you righteous whore.
Tell him, tell him what he did.
You turn your spite into civil war.
Tell him the truth
and more.
Tell him, boy, tell him how it happened, how the end doesn't mean.
it's over, how surrender is not the end. Tell 'em how the country is not what it was, where there's blood in the clover. How the nation can never again be the hope that it was. How the bruises may never be healed. How the wounds are forever. How we gave up the field, but we still wouldn't yield. How the Union can never recover from that vulgar, high and mighty nigger lover. Never, 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 never. Country is not what it was. Damn my soul, if you must, let my body turn to dust. Let it mingle with the ashes of the country. Let them curse me to hell. Leave it to history to tell. What I did well, and I did it for my country. Let them cry, dirty traitor. They will understand it later. Country is not what it was.
Johnny Booth was a headstrong fella. Even he believed the things he said. Some called him noble, some said yella. What he was off his head. How could you do it, Johnny? Calling it a cause. You left a legacy of butchery and treason we took eagerly and thought you'd get applause. But traitors just get jeers and boos, not visits to their graves. While Lincoln, who got mixed reviews because of you, John now gets only raves. Damn you, Johnny, you paved the way for other madmen to make us pay. Lots of madmen have had their say, but only for a day. Listen to the stories, hear it in the songs. Angry men don't write the rules, and guns don't right the wrongs. Hurts a while, but soon the country's back where it belongs. And that's the truth, still and all. Damn you, Boo!
Roosevelt, ladies and gentlemen, speaking to a crowd of supporters here in Miami's beautiful Bayfront Park. A group of notables are pressing in around the president-elect's car. There's Mayor Anton Cermak of Chicago. There's been a shot! I can't see. Wait! Mr. Roosevelt is waving. He's all right. But Mayor Cermak has been hit. The police have somebody in custody, an immigrant, Giuseppe Zangara. We take you now to a group of eyewitnesses who will tell us what they saw.
crowd it up close and I see this guy. He's squeezing by, I catch his eye. I say to him, where do you think you're trying to go, boy? Whoa, boy, I say, listen, you runt, you're not pulling that stunt. No gentleman pushes their way to the front. I say, move to the back, which he does with a grunt, which is how I saved Roosevelt.
Then, well, I'm in my seat, I get up to clap. I feel this tap, I turn this sap. He says he can't see, I say, find a lap and go sit on it, which is
then
how I saved.
He started to swear, he climbed on a chair. He was aiming a gun, I was standing right there. So I pushed it as hard as I could in the ear, which is how I saved Roosevelt.
Lucky I was there.
That's why he was standing back so far.
That's why when he aimed, he missed the car.
Just lucky I was there. Or we have been left bereft of FDR.
You think that I scare? No scare. You think that I care? No care. I look at the world. No good. No fair. Nowhere. When I am a boy, no school. I work in a ditch. No chance. This smart and rich. Right by. Don't give no glance. Ever since then, because of them, I have the sickness in the stomach, which is the way I make my idea to go out and kill Roosevelt. I was figure I kill Hoover. I get even for this stomach. Only Hoover up in Washington. It's winter time in Washington. Too cold for the stomach in Washington. I go down to Miami, kill Roosevelt. Don't laugh! Not funny. Men with the money, they control everything. Roosevelt Hoover, no making a difference. You think I care who I kill? I don't care who I kill, long as it's killed.
The crowd's breaking up when I hear these shots, and I mean lots.
I thought I'd plot.
I slotted
my
him.
My stomach was tied in knots.
Oh, I barreled.
He won't know what happened was this. He was blowing a kiss.
She
I was
Roosevelt.
Saying, your arrow, this weather is bliss.
When you think that we might have been seeing it miss,
lucky we were there.
It was a historical event.
Was every penny that we spent.
Just lucky we were there.
To think if I let him get up closer.
I saw right away he was insane. Oh, this is my husband, we're from Maine.
He told me to sit, but I said no, sir.
This makes our vacation a real success.
Are you with the press?
Yes.
Oh, God, I'm a mess.
Some left-wing foreigner, that's my guess.
I am left, no left, no right, no anything. Only Americans ain't gotta have nothing. No luck, no girls, ain't gotta no smart, no school, but ain't gotta no bar and tool. Ain't gotta American, American nothing. And why there no photographers? But ain't gotta no photographers. Only capitalists get photographers. No right, no fair.
Hundreds, many men to make a gun. Men in the mines to dig the iron. Men in the mills to forge the steel. Men at machines to turn the barrel, mold the trigger, shape the wheel. It takes a lot of men to make a gun. One gun,
and all you have to do is move your little finger, move your little finger, and you can change the world. Why should you be blue when you've your little finger? Prove how just a little finger can
change
the world.
What a wonder is a gun. What a versatile invention. First of all, when you've a gun. Everybody pays attention when you think what must be done. Think of all that it can do. Remove a scoundrel, unite a party, preserve the union, promote the sales of my book, ensure my future, my niche in history, and then the world will see that I am not a man to overlook. Ha-ha! And all you have to do is squeeze your little finger, ease your little finger back. You can change the world. Whatever else is true, you trust your little finger. Just a single little finger can change the world.
I got this really great gun. Shit, where is it? No, it's really great. Wait, shit, where is it? Anyway, it's just a 38, but it's a gun. You can make a statement wrong with a gun, even if you fail it. Tells them who you are, where you stand. This one was on sale. It, no, not the shoe. Well, actually, the shoe was too. No, that's not it. Shit, I had it there. Got it. Yeah, there it is.
And all you have to do is crook your little finger, hook your little finger around.
Shit, I shot it.
You can change the world. Follow through and look, your little finger can
slow them down
to a crawl, show them all,
big and small.
It took a little finger no time to change the
many men before it's done. Hundreds long before you shoot the gun. Men in the mines and in the steel mills, minute machines who died for what? Something to buy? A watch, a shoe, a gun, a thing to make the bosses richer, but a gun plays many men before it's done. Just one.
Joel Gosh, working man, born in the middle of Michigan, woke with a thought and away he ran to the Pan American Exposition in Buffalo, in Buffalo. Saw of a sudden how things were run, said time's a waste and it's 19-1. Some men have everything and some have none, so rise and shine. In the USA, you can work your way to the head of the line.
Sing the line, ladies and gentlemen. Line forms here to meet the President of the United States. Sing the line to shake hands with President William McKinley.
Joel Gosh, quiet man, worked out a quiet and simple plan. Strolled of a morning all spick and span to the Temple of Music by the Tower of Light at the Pan American Exposition in Buffalo, in Buffalo. Saw Bill McKinley there in the sun. Heard Bill McKinley say, folks have fun. Some men have everything and some have none, but that's just fine. In the USA, you can work your way to the head of the line.
Big Bill
gave him a thrill.
Big Bill
sold him a bill.
Big Bill,
who'd want to kill a man of goodwill like
Big Bill?
Doesn't the president look marvelous, so round and prosperous?
Do you know what his favorite dish is? It was in the paper. Beef!
I'm told in his spare time he enjoys collecting coins.
Joel Gosh, angry man, said, I will do what a poor man can. Yes, and there's nowhere more fitting than in the temple of music by the Tower of Light, between the Fountain of Abundance and the Court of Lilies at the Great Pan American Exposition in Buffalo. In Buffalo. Wrapped him a handkerchief round his gun, said nothing wrong about what I done. Some men have everything and some have none, that's by design. The idea wasn't mine alone, but mine, and that's the sign. In the USA, you can have your say, you can set your goals and seize the day. You're given the freedom to work your way to the head of the line. To the head of the line.
You are wind and water and sky. Jody, tell me, Jody, how I can earn your love. I would swim oceans, I would move mountains, I would do anything for you. What do you want me to do? I am unworthy of your love. Jody, Jody, let me prove worthy of your love. Tell me how I can earn your love. Set me free. How can I turn your love to me?
I am nothing. You are wind and devil and God. Charlie,
take my blood and my body for your love. Let me feel fire, let me drink poison. Tell me to tear my heart in two. If that's what you want me to do, I am unworthy of your love. Charlie, darling, I have done nothing for your love. Let me be worthy of your love. Set me free.
I would come take you from your life.
I am going to the Lordy, I am so glad. I am going to the Lordy, I am so glad. I am going to the Lordy. Glory, hallelujah. Glory, hallelujah. I am going to the Lordy.
Come all ye Christians and learn from a sinner, Charlie Gâteau. Bound and determined he'd wind up a winner, Charlie had dreams that he wouldn't let go. Said nothing to it, I want it, I'll do it, I'm Charles J. Gâteau. Charlie Gâteau never said never or heard the word no. Faced with disaster, his heart would beat faster, his smile would just grow. And he'd say,
look on the bright side, look on the bright side, sit on the right side of the Lord. This is the land of opportunity, he is the lightning, you his sword. Wait till you see tomorrow, tomorrow you'll get your reward. You can be sad or you can be president, look on the bright side.
I am going to the Lordy.
Charlie Gâteau drew a crowd to his trial, led them in prayer. Said, I killed Garfield, I'll make no denial, I was just acting for someone up there. The Lord's my employer, and now he's my lawyer, so do what you dare. Charlie said, hell, if I am guilty, then God is as well. But God was acquitted, and Charlie committed until he should hang. Still he sang.
Look on the bright side, not on the black side. Get off your backside, shine those shoes. This is your golden opportunity. You are the lightning and your news. Wait till you see tomorrow. Tomorrow you won't be ignored. You could be pardoned, you could be president. Look on the bright side.
I am going to the Lordy.
Charlie Gâteau had a crowd at the scaffold.
I am so glad.
Filled up the square. So many people that tickets were raffled. Shine on his shoes, Charlie mounted the stair. Said never sorrow, just wait till tomorrow. Today isn't fair. Don't despair.
Look on the bright side, look on the bright side, sit on the right side of the
I am going to the Lordy. I am so glad. I am going to the Lordy. I am so glad. I have unified my party. I have saved my country. I shall be remembered. I am going to the Lordy.
Look on the bright side, not on the sad side. Inside the bad side, something's good. This is your golden opportunity. You've been a preacher.
Yes, I have.
You've been an author.
Yes, I have.
You've been a killer.
Yes, I have.
You could be an angel.
Yes, I could.
Just wait until tomorrow. Tomorrow they'll all climb aboard. What if you never got to be president? You'll be remembered. Look on the bright side. Trust in tomorrow. And the
I did it to bring down the government of Abraham Lincoln. and avenge the ravaged South.
I did it to prove to her my everlasting love.
I did it to make them listen to Charlie.
I did it because my belly was on the fire.
I did it to preserve the Union and promote the sale of my book.
I did it so my friends would know where I was coming from.
Where's my prize?
I did it because no one cared about the poor man's pain.
I did it so I'd know where I was coming from.
I want my prize.
I did it because the bosses made my belly burn.
I did it so she'd pay attention.
So I'd have someplace to come from and someplace to go.
Don't I get a prize?
I did it because they said I'd be ambassador to France.
I did it so they'd suffer in the North the way we'd suffered in the South.
I deserve a fucking prize.
I did it so they'd be a trial and Charlie would get to be a witness and he'd be on TV and he'd save the world.
Where's my prize? I did it to make people listen.
Because she wouldn't take my phone call.
What about my prize?
Because nothing's stopping the fire.
I want my prize.
Nobody would listen.
It didn't mean a nickel. You just shed a little blood. And a lot of people shed a lot of tears. Yes, you made a little moment and you stirred a little mud. But it didn't fix the stomach and you've drunk your final bud. And it didn't help the workers and it didn't heal the country. And it didn't make them listen and they never said we're sorry.
Yeah, it's never gonna happen, is it? No, sir,
never.
No, we're never gonna get the prize.
No one listens.
Are we?
Never.
No, it doesn't make a bit of difference, does it?
Didn't. Never.
Fuck it.
Spread the word. Where's my prize?
I just heard on the news where the mailman won the lottery. Goes to show when you lose, what you do is try again. You can be what you choose, from a mailman to a president. There are prizes all around you, if you're wise enough to see. The delivery boys on Wall Street, and the usherette's a rock star.
Right, it's never gonna happen, is it? Is it?
No, man.
No, we'll never see the day arrive.
Let the
will we
vote
or never? No one's ever gonna even care if we're alive. Are they?
Never.
Spread the word.
There's another national anthem playing, not the one you cheer at the ballpark.
Where's my prize?
It's the other national anthem saying, if you want to hear, it says bullshit.
It says never.
It says sorry.
Loud and clear. It says listen
to the tune that keeps sounding in the distance, on the outside coming through the ground. The hearts that go on pounding to the sound, getting louder every year. Listen to the sound. Where the other national anthem pokes the ones that can't get in to the ballpark.
Spread the word.
There's another national anthem pokes for those who never win. For the suckers, for the pikers, for the ones who might have been.
There are those who like extremes. There are those who thrive on chaos and despair. There are those who keep forgetting how the country's built on dreams.
People listen.
And the mailman won the lottery.
They may not want to hear it, but they listen once they think it's gonna stop the game.
And the usherette's a rock star.
No, they may not understand all the words. All the same, they hear the music. They hear the screams.
I got news.
They hear the song. They hear the drums.
You forgot about the country.
The muffled drums. The muffled dreams.
So it's now forgotten you.
You know why I did it? Because there isn't any Santa Claus. Where's my prize?
And you forgot.
What's my prize?
I have wicked
ears. Promises and lies.
That it's a place where you can make the lies come true.
Spread the word.
If you try.
Gotta spread the word.
That's all you have to do.
Right, all you have to do.
Up hope,
up to you. The
That was the Blue Ridge Boys and Hot Egg Serenade. And now we take you live to KTEX.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was just browsing. But please, carry on with whatever you... Is that the right time? Yes? I don't know what's the matter with this watch. Excuse me for a moment.
Speaking to you from Love Field, where the president's plane has just touched down and is taxiing toward us across the tarmac. We understand the president plans to speak...
Dearest Marina, today I end my life so that your life can begin. Last night... I'm sorry, is that your note?
Fuck you!
We seem to have gotten off on the wrong foot here. It's my fault, I shouldn't have just bothered. You're not going, are you? Well, come on, I didn't mean to... Alec.
What did you call me?
Alec. You used to like that nickname back in Minsk. Marina said Lee sounded Chinese, so she called you Alec. Of course, I don't have to call you Alec, I just
thought... How do you know what Marina called me?
I know lots about you, Lee. Let's see. Born New Orleans, October 18, 1939. Father Robert died before your birth. Crazy mother, Marguerite. Dropped out of school at 17, joined the Marines. Court-martialed twice. Defected to the Soviet Union, October 1959. Defected back, June 1962. Married Marina Nikolaevna. Two children, June and Rachel. Current employment, stock boy. Texas School Book Depository, Dallas, Texas. Oh, and this morning, depressed over your estrangement from a wife who views you as a dismal and pathetic failure, you rose before dawn, kissed your sleeping children, put your last $100 and your wedding ring into a demitasse cup, which Marina's mother gave you for a wedding present, and came here to kill yourself.
Who are you?
I'm your friend, Lee.
I don't have any friends.
Yes, you do. You just haven't met them yet.
Show me your badge.
A what?
You bastards think you're so smart. I know my rights. You try to interrogate me at my place of business, I can sue you for harassment.
Ah, you think I'm with the FBI?
I have a right to see your badge.
Search me, Lee. You think I got a badge? Come on, search me. The FBI. You really love those morons, don't you? Hell, why wouldn't you? No one else cares if you live or die. Those guys can't get enough of you. How was your day, Lee? Sell any secrets to the Soviets? Sabotage any defense plants? Kick off your shoes. Tell us all about
Fuck you, whoever you are.
I'm sorry, Lee. It's just so sad. I mean, it's all you ever wanted, isn't it? Someone who won't leave you alone. Someone who wants to hear about your day. Someone, anyone. Your mother, Mother Russia, the Marines, your wife, Marina. Attention must be paid.
What's that mean?
It's from a play. About a salesman. A man very much like you, Lee. Independent, proud, a decent man who tries and tries but never gets a break. So he does something dumb. When things go really sour, when he realizes that his whole life has been a failure built on lies, he kills himself. And when he's dead, his wife stands at his grave and says, attention must be paid. She has to beg the world to pay attention to this poor, misguided nobody. Tell you something, Lee, I'm an actor, and I'm a good one. But Willie Loman is a part that I could never play. And I don't think that you should play it either.
I don't know what you're talking about.
What do you want, Lee?
You know so much, why don't you tell me?
You want what everybody wants. To be appreciated, to be valued, to be in other people's thoughts, for them to think of you and smile. You want somebody to love you, Lee, right? Isn't that it? Lee?
Yes.
Forget it.
What?
It's never going to happen. It's a fantasy. You got to give it up.
I'm going to kill myself. Don't you think I've given it up?
No, I think you're going to kill yourself because you think that's how to get it. When I'm dead, then they'll be sorry. When I'm dead, they'll know how much they love me. When you close your eyes, you probably see the funeral, don't you, Lee? A gentle rain is falling. Everybody has umbrellas.
Shut up.
There's Marina weeping quietly, a sobbing children clutching at her skirt. Your mom, your dad, every boss who ever fired you.
Shut the fuck up!
Sorry, Lee. It's just so childish. It's so dumb.
You think it's dumb? If I shouldn't kill myself, then what should I do? Go home? Beg her to take me back? Plead with her? Beat her up?
You tried all that. It doesn't work.
I know it doesn't work, so tell me what I should do.
You should kill the President of the United States.
What?
His plane landed at the airport 15 minutes ago. He's coming into town to make a speech. His motorcade is going to go right past this window. When it does, you shoot him.
You're nuts.
Maybe I am, so what?
I didn't come here to shoot the president.
He didn't come here to get shot. All your life, you've been a victim, Lee. A victim of indifference and neglect. of your mother's scorn, your wife's contempt, of Soviet stupidity, American injustice. You finally had enough. So how are you planning to get even? By becoming your own victim.
I am not a murderer.
Who said you were?
You just said I should kill the president.
Lee, when you kill a president, it isn't murder. Murder is a tawdry little crime. It's born of greed or lust or liquor. Adulterers and shopkeepers get murdered. But when a president gets killed, when Julius Caesar got killed, he was assassinated. And the man who did it...
Brutus.
Ah, you know his name? Brutus assassinated Caesar, what, 2,000 years ago? And he is a high school dropout with a $1.25 an hour job in Dallas, Texas, who knows who he was. And they say fame is fleeting.
This is stupid, up here on the sixth floor. What would I do, throw school books at him?
What's in the package?
What package?
The package that you brought to work. What's in it?
Curtain rods.
You sure?
Sure, I'm sure. Marina wanted me to take them.
That's a Mannlicher Carcano, 6.5 millimeter. Stopping range 900 yards. The sight's already been adjusted.
Who are you?
My name is John Wilkes Booth, Lee.
John Wilkes Booth shot Abraham Lincoln.
Attention has been paid. All your life you wanted to be part of something, Lee. You're finally going to get your wish.
What is this?
The past you never had. The future you'd abandoned. It's called history, Lee.
My name is Charles Guiteau. I assassinated President James Garfield.
Leon Czolgosz, William McKinley.
Sam Bick, I'm going to try to kill Dick Nixon.
John Hinckley, Ronald Reagan.
Lynette Fromm.
Sarah Jane Moore. Gerald Ford.
Zangara, FDR.
I don't get this.
It's simple, Lee.
You're going to bring us back.
And make us possible.
We're in your debt, old boy.
This bud's for you, babe.
Bravo!
Yes, Lee. Yes. What's he doing?
Getting the hell out of here.
No.
You mean he's not going to do anything?
Lee, I know things are happening kind of fast here, but you can't leave now.
No, watch me.
No, you have a responsibility here, Lee.
To who? To you?
Yes!
I'm responsible to me and to no one else.
Not anymore, Lee. 50 years from now, they'll still be arguing about the grassy knoll, the mafia, some Cuban crouched behind a stockade fence. But this... right here, right now. This is the real conspiracy, and you're a part of it.
Get out of my way.
Listen to me, Lee. You have to do this now. You won't get another chance.
So what? So I'll do something else. I'll shoot my wife. I'll shoot my kids. I won't shoot anyone. Who cares?
He wants to know who cares. I care, you stupid fool. We all care. Haven't you been listening, for Christ's sake? Are you such a vapid, vacuous nonentity? I'm sorry. John.
Yes, sir.
John, when Lee was 8, he had a dog. What was its name?
Tex.
The Marine sent him to radar school where?
The Naval Air Station, Jacksonville, Florida.
The KGB official who debriefed him in the Kremlin. What was his name and rank?
Lieutenant Colonel Boris Kutsov.
Lee, 18 years from now, when John tries to assassinate President Reagan, they're going to search his room. And you know what they're going to find? Every book about you ever written.
Can I have your autograph?
Take a look, Lee. Do you know what that is outside that window? That's America. The land where any kid can grow up to be president. The shining city, Lee. It shines so bright you have to shade your eyes. But in here, this is America, too. The mass of men lead lives of quiet desperation. An American said that, and he was right. But there are no lives of quiet desperation here. Desperation, yes. But quiet? I don't think so. Not today. Today, we are going to make a joyful noise. This is the big one. You're the big one. You're the one that's going to sum it all up and blow it all wide open. Why, after you.
Tell him. Should I tell him?
What the hell? Is Artie Bremmer here tonight? Where's Artie Bremmer?
It was a bum rap. My penis made me do it.
Who's next? Who else is out there?
Death to the enemies of Palestine.
Of course. See your hand. And James Earl Ray.
Yeehaw!
Why do these rednecks always have three names? James Earl Ray, John Wilkes Booth,
Lee Harvey Oswald.
I've seen the future, Lee. And you are it.
And now the motorcade is turning onto Elm Street. There's someone holding up a banner, all the way with JFK. The president is smiling and waving as his car heads for Dealey Plaza, where it will swing past the Texas Book Depository.
People will hate me.
They'll hate you with a passion, Lee. Imagine people having passionate feelings about Lee Harvey Oswald. Somebody, help me.
Per favore, la supplico.
Please, I beseech you.
Viviamo senza speranza.
Io ho the hopeless ones.
The lost ones.
We live our lives in exile.
Expatriates in our own country.
We drift from birth to death despairing.
Inconsolable.
But through you and your act, we dare to hope.
Through you and your act, we are revived and given meaning.
Our lives, our acts are given meaning.
Our frustrations fall away.
Our fondest dreams come true.
Today we are reborn through you.
We need you, Lee.
Without you, we're just footnotes in a history book.
Disappointed office seeker.
Deranged immigrant.
Vainglorious actor.
Without you, we're a bunch of freaks.
With you, we're a force of history.
We become immortal.
Finally, we belong.
To one another.
To the nation.
To the ages.
Bring us together, babe.
You think you can't connect? Connect to us.
You think you're powerless? Empower us.
It's in your grasp, Lee. All you have to do is move your little finger.
You can close the New York Stock Exchange.
Shut down the schools in Indonesia.
In Florence, Italy, a woman will leap from the Duomo clutching a picture of your victim and cursing your name.
Your wife will weep.
His wife will weep.
The world will weep.
Grief, grief beyond imagining.
Despair.
The death of innocence and hope.
The bitter burdens which you bear.
The bitter truths you carry in your heart.
You can share them with the world.
You have the power of Pandora's box, Lee. Open it.
I envy you.
We're your family.
I admire you.
I respect you.
Make us proud of you.
We're your family.
We're depending on you.
We're your family. Make them listen to us. We've been waiting for you. Make them listen, boy.
We're your family.
Everybody just hold tight to your dreams. Everybody's got the light to their dreams.